both of my kids, when they were born, they had terrible skin, like eczema. We didn't really know why. And with my son, he was very sickly as a child, and he was always vomiting. And when it came to the 6-month period where you're supposed to introduce milk and cereal, he had an anaphylactic reaction in the high chair, where his lips and his tongue all swelled up, and he ended up being an urgent referral to an allergist. And then that's when we found out.
I'm allergic to peanut, tree nut, basically all types of seeds. Peanuts, tree nuts, sesame, shellfish, eggs, and milk.
At the age of 2.5, he got a flick of milk out of a straw into his eye, and he was not breathing in less than 5 minutes.
I started to swell up, and I couldn't breathe. And as soon as my mom gave me the EpiPen, I took a deep breath.
I ran around that corner, counter, and hid.
Going to the grocery store initially when I was learning could take up to 2 hours to do. But if I didn't have the labeling on the containers or boxes where I could very quickly, like it's been simplified from when I first had to start doing this. So when you look at something, it's just the labeling is much clearer and much more, it's self-explanatory. Like you don't have to try and guess. I can just very easily go to the bottom of the ingredients and see out of the top 8 allergens, what is in there. Knowing especially what is in everything I buy has helped to make me feel safer and the kids feel safer, knowing that, you know, what I'm giving you is really that it is safe, that there's nothing in there that's going to make you sick.
Le Canada a un des meilleurs systèmes pour ce qui est de la salubrité des aliments et l'analyse allergène, ça ne fait pas exception. Les choses ont beaucoup évolué au niveau des allergènes alimentaires. Donc, depuis le début de ma carrière, on a vu le nombre de demandes d'analyse qui a vraiment explosé. Nous, au laboratoire, on a dû réagir à ça, y faire face, développer des nouvelles méthodes. Donc, en 2001, on avait seulement 4 méthodes. Donc, au fil des années, on a fait des projets de recherche. On a implémenté des méthodes pour chacun des allergènes qui figurent à la liste d'allergènes prioritaires du Canada. Aujourd'hui, on utilise plus de 70 méthodes pour pouvoir répondre aux demandes d'analyse. La CIA est un chef de file dans le domaine de l'analyse des allergènes alimentaires. Non seulement on utilise des technologies de pointe, mais on utilise aussi des méthodes performantes pour s'assurer que nos résultats sont fiables.
The main thing I have, I get alerts by email from CFIA about foods that either that have been recalled, basically, so that have either initially did not think that there was a food allergen in it, but then was found to have something. So I get those all of the time, and it alerts me to, did I buy this, and you know, I shouldn't be using it anymore, or changes, like changes to the ingredients to a product that maybe I have been using and that I can no longer continue using.
Ce que je trouve intéressant, c'est vraiment que mon travail a un impact sur les gens qui sont allergiques, mais pas seulement les gens qui ont l'allergie, aussi sur leur famille puis leurs proches. Le travail qui est fait ici, c'est un travail qui est important. Quand on s'aperçoit que dans le journal, au lendemain d'une journée de travail, on voit qu'il y a eu un rappel alimentaire, c'est très, très satisfaisant de penser que toute l'équipe a pu contribuer à ça aussi de belle façon. Puis, d'un certain côté, on pourrait éviter à certaines personnes allergiques de faire une réaction.